Alright.
Fucking do it live!
I need your attention for three jokes. We're already behind on time. I have three jokes. Three. I'm gonna start off by asking in the audience, how many of you have thought about killing yourself? Good.
Everybody.
Lots of smart people in the audience. The reason I say that is if you look at the world around you and you go, oh, this seems alright, chances are you're a fucking idiot. And I'll probably end up killing myself, but I like to think it's going to be on accident. I don't know how familiar you are with bipolar disorder, but I go through manic episodes where I believe I can control traffic with my mind, or I can fly, or that I'm invincible to damage. And one time in Texas, where I'm from, I jumped off a 105-foot cliff into water because I'm a man, and that's just some bitch-ass water. And when I did that, I was on a business trip with two of my colleagues. That was back before I had a denim jacket and didn't give a shit. And we were there on a business trip, and we stayed at this really nice resort, super nice. In which case, when I landed in the water, I don't have time to explain physics to you guys again due to the time constraints, but when you land in water going at 120 miles an hour, there's only one way for the water to go, which is right up your ass. Also, your legs stop working and swimming becomes difficult. So right around that point, a yacht picks me up, and I was not able to swim at that point, and I was pretty concerned drowning. You know, it's not the way I want to go, but you know, it's like, the yacht that picks me up happens to be the resort owners we're staying with. And I go, holy, oh, the owner's name is Gina. Gina, oh my God, thank you for stopping and picking me up. She goes, she pulls me up on board. She goes, the last people I put out of this water were dead. I was like, that's a pretty sombering moment. And then right around that point, I had explosive diarrhea all over her yacht. And that shit's worth living for. I've been skydiving, I've done bungee jumping, and I did cage fighting for about 4 years. And I think, like anything, you can trace any hobby back to a previous life experience. In that case, I had a bully. And I'm not talking about like one of those, I'm not talking about one of those pussy bullies, I'm talking about those bullies, they're there every day. They beat the shit out of you every time you see them, or they verbally assault you every time. I was not always the towering 5'8 stature that you see today. And this guy just loved to just fucking assault the shit out of me. And it's weird because bullies have this like weird power over you because they never go by their real name like Dave. They always go by like some sort of hyper-masculine nickname like Tank or some shit. And I remember one day when I was 12, I stood up to him. But even when I stood up to him, I couldn't call him by his like first name. I used his like bully name. So it wasn't like his biological name. But I looked at him, scared as shit, right in the face. And I said, Dad? That was my child abuse joke. You guys hung in there really well. So no matter how bad my stand-up routine goes, it was never as bad as my first time. Yeah, no, my very first time I did stand-up comedy, my mother came to the show. And my mother's an interesting character because the moment I found out she was coming to my show, I made it a point to try to like make fun of her drug addiction while she was in the audience. And so I was like, I said some joke, my mother laughed, and we had this moment, and I was like, my mother's in the audience, everyone, thank you so much, haha. If I had to rate my mother on a scale of 1 to 10, based on how many people she's fucked and drugs she's done, on a scale of 1 to 10, somewhere between 8 and Charlie Sheen. I'm kidding. Are there any parents in the audience tonight? Sir, can I see your cell phone? Can you just lift it up? Do you have it?
Yes.
That's a good point. And here's why. I'm secretly judging you. Here's why. I judge a parent based on how they treat their cell phones. And that's how I know I would never be a good one. I drop mine a lot. Oh, yes, I know. That was a cheap joke, dropping cell phones. But let's say you solve the dropping problem and you throw a helmet on that little motherfucker. How do you solve the losing problem? Because losing your kid is a lot like losing one of these new cell phones. If it's gone for, I don't know, a day, 2 days tops, chances are that little shit's dead. I do appreciate you guys hanging in there with me. Have a great night.
Let's give it up for Blake.